Hello again. This lecture is about inventory management. Firms hold different types of inventory. Raw materials, which are purchased but not used. Work in process inventory, which are materials and parts being worked on. Maintenance, repair and operating supplies, which is all you need to have but don't go into the product, such as tools, consumables and clothing. Finished goods inventory, of course, which represent completed products that are waiting shipment, often stored in a warehouse. And finally, goods in transit, finished goods that are on their way to warehouses or consumers. Obviously, a main reason is to meet demand. For make-to-stock manufacturers, holding finished goods is a consequence of the production strategy. For make-to-order manufacturers, holding raw materials and semi-finished products is needed to ensure material availability and hedge against supplier lead times. Inventories also help protect against stockouts. And this is true all the way through the supply chain, which is why you will find buffer stock, also known as safety stock, almost at every process step that are not located immediately next to each other. The longer the lead times and the higher the risks related to supplies, the higher the buffer stocks will be. There are also pure financial reasons for inventory. Often companies can reduce costs significantly by ordering large bulk deliveries of materials. Or the company simply takes advantage of price and or currency fluctuations by buying when prices are low. Companies that compete by offering a large variety of products may also choose to stock a large variety in volume of materials and parts for flexibility reasons. And of course, there's also inventory that simply exists because of the constraints in the processes. Does this mean that inventories are good? Well, yes and no. Inventories are also causing problems, which should be sought reduced. First, inventories ties up working capital. Second, they use space that need to be paid for. Third, inventories must be managed and maintained. Fourth, inventories are prone to damage, theft and obsolescence. And fifth, inventories covers up errors in the production system. I would say that generally it is better to be able to produce fast than to rely on large inventories. Now, let's introduce two basic inventory reorder systems, the reorder level system and the cyclical review system. In the reorder level system, the inventory is replenished with a fixed amount, also called the economic order quantity, whenever it hits the reorder point. For example, whenever you have only 2 rolls of toilet paper left, you stock up with a new set of 12 rolls. This simplified chart assumes an immediate replenishment when the order is delivered, which may be a good approximation for your toilet paper. But to avoid stockouts, companies must remember to add supplier lead time for replenishment. We only need 2 pieces of information to set the reorder point. First, we need the expected consumption of the material in the replenishment time. And second, we need to choose a safety stock to hedge for variation in delivery time and consumption. The trick here is to balance the cost of running out against the cost of holding extra stock. In my toilet paper example, the cost of running out can be pretty severe, so you better always have buffer stock of toilet paper. Variation and risks affect the size of that buffer stock. Remember the start of the pandemic? Most of us chose to hold a bit more safety stock of toilet paper than usual. One of the simplest reorder point systems there is called a two-bin system. You will find it in many places, in factories, in offices, and even in households. Here's how it works. Keep 2 bins of what you need close to the workstation. When the first bin is empty, order a new one. While you wait for the new bin, use the second bin. And when the new bin arrives, you will have 2 bins again. Often, the empty bin is picked up by the logistics department and simply used as an order signal for the next one. Another classic reorder level system is the economic order quantity model, which we will dedicate a separate introduction to. In the cyclical review system, the inventory is always replenished at fixed intervals or cycles. For example, every Saturday you buy milk for the next week. Rather than a set order size, orders are placed at the cyclical intervals to bring the stocks back up to a certain level. That means that there will be a different amount ordered each time. Again, safety stock is needed for any delivery lead times. Hence, in the cyclical review system, you basically just replenish what you used in the cycle. If you only drank 1 liter of milk last week, you would replenish that 1 liter of milk this Saturday. A nice advantage of the cyclical review over reorder level system is that the firm does not need to track how many parts are in stock on a daily basis, but must be able to count or read the stock level just before each order. Inventory management is a difficult task. Recall how frustrated many were due to a lack of emergency stock of basic medical equipment at the start of the corona pandemic. Some suggested countries should instead stockpile, for example, face masks in preparations of a pandemic. But storing them costs money, a lot of money, and they eventually go out of date and must be discarded. How many days of safety stock should one hold? Who should pay for it? The taxpayers? Now add all the other things a country could need in case of emergency. A variety of medicines, food and water, hospital beds, medical equipment, fire brigades, computer technologies, weapons, bullets, oil and gas. The corona pandemic led to a manifold surge in demand for face masks overnight, and nobody were prepared. My point is, we need safety stocks, but no inventory in the world can beat the capability of a country to rapidly purchase or establish production of needed materials and goods. Inventories are necessary. Can you imagine your fridge without inventories? Probably a nightmare. The challenge is to figure out the right amount of inventory to hold where and when. While this can be tricky enough for milk and toilet paper, it's a massive challenge for firms, which can separate winners from losers. Bye.